TJ Perkins rising, showcasing some of his lightning quick offense.
TJ is quick. That might be the one thing he has over Neville.
Basement drop kick.
You might be right, Austin. From what we've seen, TJ Perkins' strikes are absolutely sudden.
Speed versus strength, and it's the neckbreaker, TJ Perkins, that sends Neville to the outside again. Oh, Mark Scrupescato by the former WWE Cruiserweight Champion.
This is a great strategy by Perkins. Don't allow Neville any quarter. No time to recover. Perkins heading up top.
Yeah, there was no dabbing there. He got Neville right back in the ring, trying to finish him off.
Neville's disoriented in the center of the ring.
Meanwhile, Perkins perched on the top turnbuckle, diving crossbody. And Neville escapes. Already a champion one time here on 205 Live, but he just ate that vicious right hand from Neville, Austin.
He did. And I didn't know he played basketball, Mauro. I learned something new every evening. But right now, this is the Globetrotters.
Mauro's a big Washington Generals fan.
Of course he is.
All right, we're going to see a display of power from Neville. We saw Neville finish off Rich Swann with the superplex. Could the king of cruiserweights have the same thing in mind?
The apron is one of the most dangerous places to be in the wrestling ring.
Oh, right hand to the solar plexus by Perkins. Forearm to the face and a right hand that disorients Neville momentarily. Bring board, Frankensteiner by Perkins. Quickly goes for the cover. Wow, how did Neville kick out after that? It has been a highly competitive contest. Well, it could come down to a critical mistake by either superstar.
Oh, if Perkins is Yoda, Neville's Darth Vader. Oh. Pure dominance.
Perkins off the rope. And the speed of Neville on display. Oh, a counter roundhouse by Perkins.
Neville might be out on his feet. We're on the ropes.
Oh, triangle wrecking ball drop kick.
Perkins could be looking for the knee bar, but look at the power
at
of Neville. Completely denying Perkins' attempt.
Wow, and the strength. Oh, wheelbarrow suplex.
Beautiful.
Perkins again poised on the top turnbuckle. Neville on his feet. Oh, and he crotches TJP.
Come on. Exhaustion's got to be a factor. Perkins taking a little too long to mount the ropes, and Neville made TJ pay.
I think that was just accidental, Mauro. I don't think he tried to do that. Neville's exhausted. He just fell into the ropes.
Would you like my glasses instead of your sunglasses?
Look at this. Perkins fighting valiantly, but Neville just relentlessly moving forward.
Looking for that superplex again. Was his pièce de résistance against Rich Swann last week. Perkins fighting it off.
Perkins able to stop Neville.
Oh, man. Wow, Perkins is out on the top turnbuckle.
What a battle.
Exactly what he caught Rich Swann with last week before he finished him off with the superplex.
This is why 205 Live is the most exciting hour on television. And the king of the cruiserweights looking to finish the deed.
And Neville.
Perkins doing his best.
It's dangerous up here.
Both of them in a precarious position. Plex!
That's gotta
Neville.
Be it. That's gotta be it.
One, two, three. Neville, one step closer to becoming the king of the cruiserweights.
Here is your winner. Neville.
There's no denying Neville was in a fight. What a battle back and forth. But we said before, the key to becoming a true champion is to be able to withstand the battle and emerge victorious. And that is exactly what the king of the cruiserweights did tonight.